All right, so today we have a unexpected type of repair and a video for you guys. Me and Leo actually blew up the radiator the other night, ripping up the hill. So what I did was got all new, brand new Michimoto radiator, transmission cooler, and intercooler. And that's what we're gonna be doing today. Let's just show how fucking much water this fucking thing holds. There she goes. We're gonna take these pipes off the intercooler here. Get those off and then we'll Alright, so I just loosened up these clamps to the pipes, the charge pipe from the intercooler. We'll pop off this AC condenser, rotate it up, and the intercooler should just come straight out. No, looks pretty rad. Really. Tens. So the new transmission cooler with the Michimoto, you do have to come in here and cut these rubber hoses right here. Michimoto says it's kind of about 5 inches back from the hump, so probably somewhere right up in there. And they give you some new lines and some ends here. That's what's gonna go right there. And these will feed into your transmission cooler. So that's what we're gonna do right now. We're gonna chop those off. Seal them up, pull this out, and pull the radiator out. So we just cut those off. We had these ready with the nipples, so we can plug it off pretty quick and just have these hose coming out of the top up here until we get everything else out, and then we'll finalize it. All right, this is probably gonna be the easiest part. Now the radiator. Alright, now we got the transmission cooler out. Now the last thing is gonna be the radiator. We're gonna pull the hoses off, the fan shroud off, and then the shit just pull right up out of there. Alright, we got all the hoses off. All that's left is this little, it's gonna be your power steering cooler. Maybe 2 13s. I'm gonna get this. Let's see right here. That's gonna come off. Those are 2 13s on each side. Move that out. Move the fan shroud forward. And this should come right out. All right, we pulled out the fan shroud already. This is just pull straight out to the fan. I'm pulling off this piece right here. It's gonna be, it's held on by two 13s right there, held on to the radiator. Now we have two 10s right here in the corner. Pull those out, and then your radiator will come straight out. Oh, I guess we found out the problem. Look at the fucking tank clutch. I'll just go through what the fuck happened here. Yeah, so that's why there's a hole in the radiator. The fan clutch decided to exit out. Interesting, look at that shit. Holy shit. Yeah, that was supposed to be somewhere in there and then it fucking blew out. So that's what happened. Look at this shit, bro. This fucking came coming out. About Mach 1 right there.
Boom!
That's why she don't work no more.
Oops.
Cause she got smashed by the fucking fan clutch. Okay, well. Dude, that thing is gone, bro. That's why there's so much oil in there, too.
Mm-hmm.
This shit. Everywhere. I'll slap this thing right back in there. Everything here. This thing's actually very light. We got this in there. I got the two bolts. I'm just gonna start putting in these hoses and pretty much put everything back together one step at a time. All right, this is the transmission cooler. So it's all ready to go here. Oh, that's what I was talking about. What's that important piece that I told you? Remember I told you the important piece? All right, so we're gonna do a thermostat bypass on the transmission cooler. I don't live in it. Cold enough climate to keep it really. So we're just gonna pull everything off here. Dude, this thing feels like it's on some fucking pressure. What if it just poof? There's a spring in here. Dude, this thing feels like. What if it blew? Oh, there it goes. Alright, so we have these piece. Oh god. Hold by that piece. Alright, so when we do a thermostat bypass, we take out this whole fucking thing right here. and then it goes right back in. Oh, dude. Now she's under some pressure. These lines here, transmission lines that we cut earlier. Are you filming still?
Mm-hmm.
Should I make them or should I cut them? I should probably cut them a little bit shorter. All right, so we got our transmission lines hooked up here. We got a charge pipe. There's a charge pipe down here too. Yep, there's that charge pipe. We're gonna get the boots on and then we'll slap the intercooler right on. Alright, we got Eli holding the AC condenser. We got the boots ready to receive the intercooler. Get that out of the way. It should just slap right in. Alright, sorry guys, the camera died last night. We were finishing it up, but we installed it really quick. So that's nothing too crazy with the intercooler. It's pretty much just come at an angle. You have two hangers on the inside that hang on this bar. And then just line it up, get them in your hoses. I put a little bit of lube on the inside. So it's nice, little, quick, easy. I'm not struggling right there. I'm trying to put the hose on and hang it at the same time. So it's up pretty quick on. And we stopped at my buddy's at NOS Auto Works. In town, we extracted the refrigerant of the AC system, swapped out the old AC condenser, put a new one in. This one's from, I don't remember what this one's from. I have to look it. It'll be in the description though. I'm gonna have to look it up. But yeah, I got a silver one. You know, if you notice, a lot of them come in black, but I like that. I'm trying to go stay with the Mishi Metal color, so I'm gonna hang on a silver one. But yeah, there's all it is, man. EGTs are way down. And yeah, quick walk around here. As always, guys, thanks for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like. If you guys have any questions or anything, leave in the comments. I'll get to them. And yeah, if you guys want some more, go ahead and subscribe. We've got a couple videos coming up soon with work and everything. I'm trying to get some more videos out, but we're working on the shop here, so the shop should be up the end of the year sometime. So once that's up, we're rolling deep. So be sure to subscribe, be ready for it. Thanks, guys.